Howdy virtual farmers, welcome back to FernyForge. I'm Nick and we're diving right back into the lush fields of Farming Simulator 2022. So if you caught our debut, you know we started from scratch on a challenging Haut-Beyleron map. Today, it's all about progress and exploring new avenues in our budding farming empire. In our last episode, we sold our farmhouse, made a little bit extra cash from it. We tackled some contracts and did some serious landscaping. Today, we're steering our farm in exciting directions and there's so much more to unfold. From mastering new equipment to expanding our farmland, today's episode is all about growth and pushing the boundaries of our farming empire. So stick around, hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, and let's cultivate some more gaming greatness together. Now let the farming adventures continue. So today we're going to be looking into some more farming contracts as our farm isn't quite ready for harvest yet. So first off, I'm going to top up our fertilizer, fill it up to the brim, and see what fertilizing contracts we can do. Now, obviously, we did a bunch of them yesterday, so there isn't that many going today. However, there's still money to be made, so we're going to grab that money where we can. Okay, right, so we've got cultivating. We aren't going to touch any cultivating. We are going to stick to some fertilizing. We only have small fertilizing contracts available and a ton of plowing. So I think the best thing we could possibly do is just accept one fertilizing contract, get two of these plowing contracts on the go, and get AI doing these whilst we work our way through the fertilizing ones. Because this will be some extra cash which we won't have to put any effort into. We'll start off with the biggest one. So we're going to use our own equipment for fertilizing because that is what we bought the equipment for. And the other two contracts, we are going to pick the two most expensive ones. Now we're going to make sure we borrow the items this time because I made that mistake yesterday where I forgot to borrow the items. I'm just going to accept one at a time though, so then I do send the correct worker to the correct farm. Okay, so we'll jump in this tractor here, and I believe, hold on, let's have a quick look. This one is going to field 45, and then once we've got this at field 45 and he's ready to go, then we can actually start thinking about our fertilizing. Now we are going to do one at a time, like I said, so we can make the most out of our AI workers. So where is field 45? Let's have a look on the map. I do believe it's right down at the bottom again, and it is, so it's this one just down here. We are, rather than actually going there, we are just going to set the destination like so, so we don't have to actually drive him ourselves. So once he arrives there, we can then set him off to fully plow that field, because obviously we're going to be doing a bunch of fertilizing. Now let's go back into the contracts and let's get our second plowing contract on the go. Now we're going to go for this one here for just short of £8,000. Now obviously when we're leasing equipment, our reward is reduced. Now this one is £1,208. I ain't going to be complaining about small amounts of money like that when I'm going to be making around £4,000 from the AI themselves. Okay, so we'll make sure that we borrow those items. And this one is going to field 6. Okay, so let's get this guy ready to go. If I can attach the plow, that would be nice. There we go. And rather than driving there ourselves, again, I am just going to get the AI to drive it all the way up to number 6, which is just here. Okay, so I will get him to drive to around there. Let's do that. There we go. Now we're both on the way and we can now focus on fertilizing some crops for other farmers. So we don't quite have enough space for 2 bags of fertilizer, but I'm just going to buy 2 anyway, because we can always go back and top ourselves up. So that's £3,640. Now I know it seems like a lot of money when the contracts are only around £3,000 each, but in the long run it's going to be totally worth it. There we go, let's refill you. That's 1 bag gone. So I do apologise if I do start sniffling. I have got a bit of a cold at the moment. It's quite common with this weather here in the UK. Best route to go, I'm probably going to go around the river rather than going past the farm, because I think that's probably the quickest route. Just hold your horses, let's see what's going on with this AI. It said he was blocked, but he's no longer blocked. But now we are actually here, I will get him started on this job here. So I do believe it's this field. This field already looks like it's been ploughed, but something's grown on it and then died. Now that's probably due to me not accepting a contract of some form, I don't know. But we will just get him started anyway. Let's zoom out a little bit. And this way we don't have to wait around as long if we are doing our stuff whilst the AI is at work. So we're not quite at 270 degrees, but I'll let him off this time. Okay, and this guy has arrived at this farm too. So we'll get him started as well. And then we've got a little bit of passive income coming in from both of these AI workers then. So we'll just unfold that. Let's get ourselves at 180 degrees. There we go. And we can start ploughing. Go on, start ploughing then. And there we go. Both of them are set off. And they're ready to make me some passive income now. So whilst they are doing their jobs, I'm going to try and cover the costs of them working by doing some fertilization. Now I should be, like, based on how small these fertilizing contracts are, I should be able to get the rest of the fertilizing contracts done in the time they are doing their plowing. Now I'm hoping that's the case anyway, so we will see. Hold on, which farm is it? Number 35. Now I've actually never even touched this piece of land before, so let's have a quick look and see what sort of shape we are about to have a go at. Okay, so it's a bit of a odd shape. I'm thinking that maybe we should go horizontally instead of vertically, just because of these angles here. These angles can make it a little bit awkward sometimes. Gonna start at the bottom and work my way up. That way I can do my maths pretty easily. If you remember from episode 1, I just add 42 meters onto the coordinates down there at the bottom. Oh, I don't like this farm at all. It's got quite a few trees around it. Oh, come on, off you go. Go through. Come on. Okie dokie. So I am going to see where this farm starts. And it starts at 1456. Now I think actually I'm going to go to the other end, just so then I'm not having to minus things. I can just add the 42 on. I did get that the wrong way around. However, I can't always get everything right now, can I? So this farm starts at 1304. So I will start fertilizing at 1325. Just around here, and make sure that we are at a 90 degree angle. You know what, 1322 is fine. I don't mind having a little tiny bit of an overlap, and we can start fertilizing this crop here. I will start my cruise control because it will make it much faster, much easier for me to do, and I can have a look around whilst we are doing it. But already we've done 10% and we've only just started. We can stop that. So 1322 we're at, so 1364 will be our next point of entry. So we'll say just around here. Let's make sure we're on that 90 degree angle. And there we go. Rightio. Now we've hardly used any of our fertilizer so far, so I don't think this farm is actually going to require much. 33%. And we're 7% down, so we should be left with around 79% of our fertilizer by the end of this contract. Okay, there we go. I will just do that. Right, so 1362 will bring us to 1404. Somewhere around here will do perfectly. Make sure we're at that 90 degree angle. There we go. And off we go for that one. So today we are going to be focusing on doing as many contracts as possible, so then we can build up as much money as we can. Already, we've already paid off the plough, we've already paid off the fertilizing tool, so we are basically in the profits so far. 1446 being the next one. Now I think that will do just here. That should reach the end. And this contract will actually be done any moment now. And we can move on to our next and make a little bit more money. Come on, man. 93%. That should be 100. There we go. Okay, so we'll make sure we collect our money for that. So then we can go and accept another contract straight away. Oh, so it's £3,702. That is not bad. So we'll collect that. And now we're going to move on to this one, which is Field 41, which is down at the bottom of the map. So yeah, it is the farm next to my farm. Got to make sure that I don't go over my crops, because I do have crop destruction on. However, I think that crop destruction only actually destroys crops whilst you are harvesting them. Because I've never known it to get destroyed whilst they are still growing, otherwise you wouldn't be able to fertilize them and stuff like that. So I don't know why I've come this far along, because obviously we do want to start. Bless you, Sockies. The cat is sneezing. I think we're all a little bit flued up here. What's that? 1525 plus 21, that's 1546. Okie dokie. I'm sorry about all the maths. However, when it comes to actually farming, you do need to do a lot of maths so you don't waste any materials whatsoever. Alright, let's stick our cruise control on again. It should be a nice, quick and easy farm to fertilize as well. To be honest, I think they all are pretty fast and easy, the ones we have left. I think we might have missed a little bit from that, but it's fine. 89 being the next point of entry. Oof, there just has to be a tree in the way, don't there, every time. And go on that 90 degree angle, there we go. And stick our cruise control back on. I think that this is a cornfield as well. They're quite high. 63% complete already. And then the next point is going to be 1332. Okay, I don't want to touch my fields just in case we do destroy. This should probably be our last length of on this farm, so we should be done just about halfway down this row. Come on, any time now. There we go, turn that off. And we can accept this guy as well. So this one's at 17%, this one's at 9%. And we can collect our money from that. That was a nice, easy money again. And these two are going to be rather easy as well. So our next one's going to be Field 39. And that's for a measly £2,000. Now we should actually be able to finish both of these contracts with what we have in our fertilizer currently. Okay, so we'll accept that one. And we're going to Field 39. Oh, it's right next to us as well. That's good. That means we don't have to travel far to get to it. Okay, I think this one we're going to go lengthways. And we're going to start from the far side and then work our way over. Oh, I nearly went into my farm there. I'm just going to guess the 21 meter mark for this farm. I don't think it matters all that much when you're doing other people's farms. But when you're doing your farms, you want to make sure you hit every square inch of the farm. So again, stick cruise control on. Already we're at 10%. I do like these small jobs because you can go from one to the other. Yes, the pay does reflect just how much you're doing. But that's fine, that's fine. 1672, ooh, didn't mean to do that. 1672 being the next spot, or aroundabouts there. There we go, 90 degrees. 1670 will do the job. Tiny little bit of overlap, but that's fine. It's not going to keep me awake at night. And then I think there's only going to be around 25 to 30 metres left. So I will change my worker width to 36 metres, and then just come to here, and then let's finish off this field, trying to not waste much fertilizer at all. And this should be done any minute now. There we go. Brilliant. That's another fertilizing contract done, and now we've got this little tiny one, which is field one, which is in the top left corner. That's quite a distance to travel. I'm going to do it anyway, just because these guys are going to take a little bit longer than I had hoped. We may be waiting for them for a while, so I might have to find something for me to do in the meantime. I don't want to be sat there doing too many time lapses today. I want to try and do as much manual labour as possible. So we'll accept that one and we'll start making our way to field one. What we're going to do though is, on our way there, we're just going to pick up the last tiny bit of our fertiliser which we left back at the shop. It's on our way anyway, so it's fine. It's not a waste of fuel or anything like that. And I will just reset my worker width So we're back at 42 meters. But I think what we may end up doing is I might accept a cultivating job next. Let's have a quick look. So we've got that one. And we've got one harvesting job, which I'm not too interested in doing just because it requires quite a bit of effort to do. So yeah, I think we're going to do a cultivating job. Hopefully we can use a cultivator with this tractor because it's not a very powerful tractor. Made a mistake at the beginning of not having an upgraded engine. And if you didn't catch the first episode, you'll see exactly what I mean. And if you haven't, but make sure you go back and check that out. No, we won't go up there. We will continue through the village because it is a top left corner. So I don't really want to be cutting through people's farms and stuff like that. Not as though they'd notice or even mind. But it just makes sense to just go to the edge of the map and work my way up to the top corner. Today's episode isn't going to be an hour long though. I'm hoping that we can cut it down to around 40 minutes. I did aim for the last episode to be 40 minutes. But I got a little bit carried away with the contracts. However, it's probably not the best idea when you are a brand new channel starting out here on YouTube. So how far is he through this field here? It looks like he's making some decent progress. It's going a bit slow, but I think that might be due to the incline on the hill, which won't help at all. Now, I don't think I've ever actually been to field one before either. You'd think I would have fully explored this map, but I actually haven't. I'm normally down in the bottom right corner, doing my own thing down there. It is quite a lovely map though, and I bet there's some really nice spots up here for some nice little screenshots, which I might just do. Okie dokie, here we are. Wow, this is a tiny field, isn't it? It should be done in minutes. Not even going to measure this one. Wait, did I fill up? Oh, I can't remember now. Alright, so we'll go down to 292 or thereabout. And this one should actually be done any moment now. Like I say, another nice, quick and easy contract. Come on. There we go. And that's that contract done too. So, pretty easy. Pretty easy money. Now, I know it didn't seem worth it, but already today we are £33,000 up. We made £47,000 in contracts with around £15,000 awaiting us with the other contracts we've got. But that's pretty good going. It's nearly 10% of our balance earned today. And by the end of the day, it should be at least 10% of what we have we will have earned just today, which is brilliant. Right, so let's have a look at some of these cultivating contracts. £4,800 or £4,467. Before we do, let's have a quick look into some cultivators. In fact, let's check the shop out. Is that a cultivator? No. Oh, that's a cultivator. I haven't used one of these before. So this is a cultivator here. Now, £7,000 seems like a pretty good deal. So it does 3 meters wide. Now, if we're doing small contracts, that might just be enough. We'll have a look at other cultivators though first. I don't see that cultivator in here anywhere, which I find a little bit odd. We can work up to about this one here with our current setup. Where else would they be? Is there any other cultivators? Okay, so it's a power harrow. I believe that these actually attach to a seeder of some form, maybe. Right, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to drive back to the shop and check to see what sort of upgrades I can do. See if I can upgrade my engine, because I could do with a little bit extra power. I'm pretty sure with some tractors, you can upgrade the engine size. Now, I probably should have thought about this before, but I've only just realised myself. And whilst we are making our way back, we can check to see progress again going on over here. Now, yet again, he hasn't made much progress. Now, this is why I don't like doing ploughing contracts, because they just take forever to do. He's about 30%, maybe 25% through that. It is a big field, though, so it will take a little bit longer. Whilst we're doing that, let's have a look. 7 acres for that one, and just short of 8 acres for that one. So I think what we're going to do just now is we're just going to observe these workers for a moment and see just how well they are doing. I never did pick up this fertilizer. Well, I can do it now. Here we go. It's only a little tiny bit anyway. And we will just check to see if we can upgrade our engine. Will we repair it? It's only 479. Let's keep it in tip-top condition. Yeah, so this is as big of an engine you can get for it. Okay, so let's go and quickly observe these guys. And I'm just going to have a short time-lapse to see what sort of progression they're making. I need to take my fertilizer back to my farm. I probably should have bought an extra fertilizer bag and topped up what I've got in here. However, I think we've only got one more month where we can actually get fertilizing contracts. But what we're going to do tomorrow, a bit like I said last episode, I'm going to wake up at 7 because there's not just me competing for these jobs. Drop that off. I'm not sure if I'll need my front weight or not. And let's just have a look. Let's see just how much of a contract these guys have finished. And field 45, he's nearly halfway there. As field 6 seems to be struggling, I think it might be them hills. So what I might actually do is get myself set up with my plough and go and meet him at that farm to finish off the farm with him, because he's going to be a while otherwise, and we want to get these contracts done sooner rather than later. That way we can move on to tomorrow, where hopefully we can do our final set of fertilizing and make some big money, hopefully. We'll see. Now, I know from last episode that this tractor isn't quite powerful enough to pull this plough. However, we're just going to have to make do at the moment and do as much as we can off the resources we currently have. Okay, I probably shouldn't have got a 7-bladed plough. I probably should have got the 5-bladed plough. However, each blade is like half a meter. So, you know, when it comes to doing a couple of lengths of one field, they add up very fast. They really do. So I'm not going to go up this one. I'm going to carry on until there's the bridge. Now, apparently there are a bunch of collectibles in this game. I'm not sure if they are on this map. I haven't seen one yet. So, if they are, then I'm not doing a very good job of looking out for them. But I know that they're all over Elm Creek. You can find cows, sheep, pigs, trailers, and all sorts, really. Whereas, I haven't stumbled upon any of them on this map so far. We're going to start on this side. Up you get. There we go. And I'm hoping that is a 90 degree angle. So, let's unfold our plough. And let's get started over here. And we will just get the AI doing this, just because we do a better job with the power we've got being delivered from this tractor at the moment. Right, well, it seems that we are making some good progress here. Let's check these out. Now we have number 45, which is at 67%, and the one we're currently on, field 6, is at 48%. I am going to leave my tractor here to help him get through this, because the AI guy over there is struggling quite a bit to get through it. So I'm going to make use of my tractor as well. So then we can obviously finish this contract much faster, and we can move on to tomorrow then, because I think we've hit the peak for today, in all honesty. I will just check again. Now, I don't think any of these other ploughing jobs are actually worth our time. And to be honest, I don't think these two were either, but I've kind of started them now and I want to finish them now I've started them. So thinking about these cultivating jobs, these might actually be worth doing, especially this one here, because I think that cultivator is bigger than the blue one is bigger than the red one. We'll just double check actually. Let's have a look at some cultivators. So it's a tough one really. That's 8.4 meters. And I think that's the one which comes with that job. I think that's the one for the other job. Based on the cost,
of leasing the equipment, I think that this one might actually be worth doing. I might manually do this myself. I'm going to borrow the items anyway, and we'll see what we can do in respect to that. Ooh, this tractor sounds cool. It's strange how this tractor's cheaper to lease than that other one, when the equipment is actually slightly better. And where are we going to? Field 29. I'll just check that on the map. 29 is just over here. That's a nice square one. I do like a square field. It does make life much easier. So I'm going to head over there now and work on this next contract. And I think what I might do, based on our discovery from yesterday, is once our worker is finished with field number 45, I might move that plow to field 6 and get him to assist with the plowing up there as well. Because field 6 is taking much longer than I had anticipated, which means it's going to cost me a lot more money, especially with hiring workers. So this cultivation job will probably just about cover around, I guess, 60% of today's wages, which ain't too bad. It's not the end of the world. I don't mind losing a little bit of money so long as I'm making profit on all the jobs in total. I'm gonna cut across this field because it's only been ploughed. Has that been cultivated? One or the other. I think it's just on the other side of field 30. Right, here we are. Let's unfold it, see just how wide it is, and we can get him lined up just like so. Let's do that and then do that. We should, that should just be just about enough. Now if we can line him up with the world at a 90 degree angle, we can start cultivating this field. So contract on field 6 is 60% complete now. He's working much faster since I've got the second tractor on it. Like I was saying, I'm going to lose a bit of money by doing that now. Like I was saying before, I don't mind missing little gaps, because when you complete the contract, they fill in the gaps for you anyway, so you don't have to be perfect when doing these contracts. Already we're at 20% complete, which is pretty good going. Now guys, I need you to remind me to not accept these ploughing contracts again, because they just seem to take up way too much time. I don't mind doing some time lapses of them, so if you do want to see more of them, I can do more time lapses in the future. However, it's probably not the best use of my time. It's probably not the best use of money either. I do love this tractor though. The tracks make it look really cool. It's like a tractor tank. Tractor with tanks in mind. So right now, I've only done farming simulator videos, and I'm debating on what to do next. Do I keep it so then I mostly do farming sims? Or should I actually move on to something else as well and sort of sporadically add multiple series as we move forward? Obviously, I'm quite new to all of this. This is the first time I've done this in a very long time. I do work a full-time job as well as doing this, so I do plan on having at least minimum one video a week. I think that would be quite suitable. However, I wouldn't mind making this my full-time job. However, my full-time job is, well, I'm a teacher. That is what I do. I actually teach the next generation of kids how to make games. So I am a games designer as well. And I've been making games for a very long time. And at some point, I will show you guys some of the stuff I've made. And whilst the channel is still small, I'm going to keep that side of me away from this channel for now. But if giants want to give me a job making the next farming simulator, I will not be saying no to that. That would be awesome. I'm making really good progress actually with this cultivation. I'm just going to hire a worker though, just so I can check on these other guys. Now this one's nearly done, and this guy's nearly done over here too. So should be able to hand in all of these contracts at around the same time. I think now that he's not on that big part of the hill, he's actually able to make progress a lot faster. Right, let's have a quick look and see just how far they are through. So, one's at 93%, so that's the one at the back. And this one's at 86%. It does seem like I've done more than that, but it's at 86%. Cultivation's at 60%, which is great. It's much faster to cultivate than it is to plough. I think I turn a little bit better than he does as well. Although, I have been missing little spots here and there. But like I've been saying, it's not my field, it's not my farm, so it ain't going to keep me awake at night. I'll continue this myself. Save a little bit of money somewhere, right? I've got a feeling that the other two on field 6 are going to collide pretty soon. Couple more runs up and down here and we should be pretty damn close to finishing, and I'm hoping that the other ploughing jobs will be finished too. There we go, contract on field 6 is complete. I will just stop him. That's field 6. Okay, I ended up being done much faster than I was expecting. Oh, and this one is now finished too. Brilliant. Okay, I have got the AI finishing off this one for me for now. I'll just collect all of this money and I shall drive my tractor back home. Let's rotate my plough though, because he left it on the opposite side, and then straighten it out. There we go. Ooh. There was a bit of a weight differentiation there. Just trying to zoom in. Come on, there we go. It's a bit frustrating how you can't zoom in whilst you hold an acceleration down. I think that's because this is a manual gearbox and you use the arrows to also change your gears. And whilst you are accelerating, it will change your gears for you. I think I'm going to refuel this guy as well. 90% complete on field 29. Need to keep an eye out for that, so we don't go over. If you look at our money though, we're at £394,000. Now considering we started at 500 grand, we bought a piece of land, sold, ooh, poor dear. Oh dear. considering we started with £500,000, we sold a house, making our money straight back, and we bought a bunch of equipment too. Like I think we spent around 150 grand just on equipment alone. So we seem to be doing all right. I am going to repair. I've decided I'm not going to do any more ploughing contracts as well. That's £54. Oh, that was for the wrong one. Oh, £62 and £5. It is really expensive to repaint these things. So yeah, I think in the future, unless it's a fertilizing job, I'm not going to use mine. And I think the more your paint is worn down, the faster your vehicles and equipment deteriorate. Well, don't quote me on that. It's just an observation. There we go. Field 29 complete. I will dismiss him and collect that money. There's another 4.5 grand. And we spent £5,393 on wages today. But we made £64,000 just on contracts alone. So already we're 45 grand up on the day, which is fantastic. It's what we want to see. And I think that is going to be it for our second month here at the FernyFarm. All right, so turn my engine off. Let's have a look, see what contracts are available. Mostly ploughing, we've got harvesting, cultivating. I'm not going to bother these. This one's going to take much longer than the one I've just done because the width of that cultivator isn't the same as the width of the one I've just been using. And harvesting can be quite time consuming as well, because you have to move the crops and drop them off. And the grain mill, I think that's the top left of the map. We're going from the middle of the map to the top left of the map, so it'll take quite a while to do that. Okay, so I think that's it for today. Let's go to sleep and see what arises tomorrow for us. So yeah, we are going to wake up an hour earlier, 7 a.m. Rightio, let's have a quick look. Yeah, there's no fertilizing jobs. I'm not going to be touching any baling. I'm not going to be doing any harvesting either, or ploughing. Our crops, though, should be either ready today or ready tomorrow to be harvested. Oh, they are ready to harvest today. Brilliant. And there you have it, fellow virtual farmers. Our fields are thriving. Look at this corn. We've completed a bunch of contracts. And I'm hoping that the anticipation is building. But hold your tractors, because in our next episode, we're diving headfirst into the golden sea of corn. That's right, we're saving the grand harvest for our next farming adventure. I can almost hear the corn stalks rustling already. So don't miss out, hit that subscribe button, ring the bell, and join me as we reap what we've sown in the next episode here at FernyForge. If you enjoyed this episode, give it a thumbs up and share your thoughts in the comments. Your support means the world to me, and I can't wait to continue this farming journey with all of you. Until next time, happy farming!